Hello everyone. In this video, I will make a quick comparison between two analog multimeters, the Sanwa YX-361TR and the Hioki High Tester 3030-10, and their most important difference. The Sanwa tester has a rich feature of manual ranging functions, excellent for electronics hobby or repair use. However, it has no CAT rating, not even CAT1, so in my opinion, it's suitable only for bench use, due to its electronics-centric functions. Do not use it on power panel boards or branch circuit breakers. The Hioki tester is rated at 600 volts category 3, which means it can be safely used in residential panel boards and branch circuit breakers. It is also good for testing small electronic components, although it did not include some functions found in the Sanwa tester. Both of them have built-in battery tester for 1.5-volt tri-cell batteries, which is very useful, and an LED tester. The Sanwa YX-361TR came with its non-standard test leads, which will not fit any other tester but just this Sanwa meter. It also didn't have a stand. The Hioki 3030-10 was shipped with a carrying case, which can be used also as a stand. The Hioki's test leads and input terminals are standard. You can even use a pair of Fluke test leads on this Hioki analog tester. This is a pair of Sanwa TL61 test leads. The 361TR will only accept these test leads. As you can see, the cable insulation is thinner and its tips are fully exposed, indicating that it is intended only for low power, low voltage electronics bench use. The Hioki L9207-30 test leads, on the other hand, are thicker and have removable caps that allow it to match the 600 volt category rating of the tester. This means that it can safely be used to test voltage in residential panel boards or fixed branch circuit wiring. The Sanwa YX-361TR has a clear lens and bright white scale plate. All the scale figures are sharp and clean. It is fuse and diode protected. The mirror arc on the ohms scale helps reduce reading error. The red LED provides visual indication of continuity, and a health bar is used for checking 1.5-volt dry-cell batteries. The rear cover provides important safety information at a glance. Be sure to read it as well as the user's manual for proper and safe operation of the tester. This particular unit is made in Japan. The Hioki 3030-10 also features a faceplate that's clear and bright. It is notable for its large numbers, but missing the mirror. It is, however, drop-proof by 1 meter on concrete. The internally magnetized tote band is quick and smooth. Its user's manual states that it is fuse and diode protected. The black scale quickly gives visual information of battery health. There is a temperature scale also, but it needs a special probe that's no longer available. Its rear cover shows important safety information, including fuse rating and battery. Again, be sure to read also the user's manual and follow the instructions for proper and safe use of the tester. This multimeter is made in Japan as well, high quality and accurate. This is a close-up of the circuit board of the Sanwa tester. You can clearly see the 500 mA 250-volt glass fuse and spare, compartments for the 9-volt and two 1.5-volt batteries. The 9-volt battery is necessary for resistor testing up to 20,000 kilo-ohms and the autopolarity function. Meanwhile, this is the circuit board of the Hioki tester. There is only a compartment for the two 1.5-volt batteries, but notable is the 500 mA 250-volt non-arcing ceramic fuse protection and spare. It does not need a 9-volt battery, so its resistor testing can only go as high as 3,000 kilo-ohms. Let's do some sample testing. Selecting X1K using the 0 ohms adjuster and taking measurements. Both testers register 17 kilo ohms. Notice how smoothly the indicator needle swings. There is no bounciness whatsoever on both test equipment. The Hioki meter, however, was a bit quicker. Testing the voltage of my CR2032 Bolton type battery. Notice how the indicator needle swings to the left due to the reverse polarity of the test leads. Try to avoid this by getting the polarity correct from the start. Both instruments register 3 volts DC. Testing the null DC voltage or the auto polarity function of the Sanwa meter. This is convenient if you just want to test for DC voltage value regardless of polarity. This is not found in the Hioki tester. Testing for the AC voltage of an outlet using my demonstration board. This is considered Cat 1 rating location, where the Sanwa tester was not specified for. This is a controlled setting so we can safely observe the AC voltage measurement function of the YX-361TR. On the other hand, this is well within the safe cut rating of the Hioki meter. Both of them read the same 240 volts AC, which is close enough to 237 volts displayed by the digital meter. Now let's try the 1.5 volt battery health tester. First, I will use the 2.5 volts and 3 volts DC manual range respectively. It reads 0.7 volts, not totally empty. Next, let's use the dedicated battery tester and read the results at the health scale bar. In this function, the meter will introduce a load of around 6 ohms for the Sanwa and 10 ohms for the Hioki tester. As you can see, the indicator needle didn't even flinch. This battery is totally depleted. Let's try another one. This battery is better, but barely. It may be able to power small transistor radios or TV remote controls, but it should be replaced as soon as possible. The continuity or the X1 resistor testing. When testing for continuity, the Sanwa meter benefits from the visual indication of the red LED at the top right corner. Here both instruments register about 22 ohms. The X10 resistor function is good for testing LEDs too. So long as the correct polarity connection is observed, all that's necessary is to observe that they light up and the needle reading can be ignored. in summary, the IEC 61010 is an international safety standard for electrical test equipment. The CAT ratings are safety boundaries that tells you how far into the electrical system you can go with your electrical test equipment. And this is where the most important difference between these two analog testers rest. The Sanwa YX-361TR was not specified for any IEC 61010 category rating, not even CAT 1, which is the lowest. So this is not an oversight on the part of the manufacturer. Rather, it tells you that the meter is meant for electronics bench use only. The user's manual tells you as much and reminds you with a note at the back cover. In this regard, this is an ideal instrument due to its electronics-centric functions. On the other hand, the Hioki 3030-10 can also be used as an electronic bench multimeter, although it does not include the few items found in the Sanwa tester. But since this Hioki is specified according to IEC standard 61010 at 600 volts category 3, you can safely use it to test for voltage up to the main power distribution board, but not at the service entrance. It is also built more rugged and provided with a strong carrying case for this particular purpose. These are fine instruments when used according to their purpose, and follow the instructions for the correct and safe use of your analog testers. Thank you for watching and safe testing.